tell or give us a bit in-depth look into MySQL management and monitoring. A quick notice before we start, starting at 1 p.m. we will have some massaging offer over at the Salon Clara, which is the business lounge over there. So if you've got a tight neck, it might help a massage. So enjoy and you can start.
Hello, hello. Okay. Yeah, as promised yesterday evening, I will continue my presentation now here. It's not about knives now, but about MySQL management and monitoring. Yeah, I'm working for Thomas Grenage. Okay. One moment. Good that it's before lunch, so. Okay. So, and our situation is that we are running a web shop and we are selling our systems mainly in an online shop. So the thing is that it's very important that our system is highly available. We have about 100 employees at the moment and over 10,000 customers. And we are running the classical Linux, Apache, MySQL, PHP stack. And my presentation, of course, is about MySQL management and monitoring mainly. I try to remove. Okay. Okay, not so easy. Yeah. No, it's fine. So, my presentation is about MySQL management and monitoring. We are running MySQL 5.5 at the moment. It's currently the latest stable version. We have one master that is highly available with DBD. We are using DBD since many years and have quite good experiences with it. And moreover, we have added one MySQL slave in the past to get some kind of load balancing. And we have the situation that we are doing the hosting internally in a data center in Frankfurt, and the programming is done by an external company. So there are many questions for me because I'm responsible somehow for the infrastructure behind and the systems for the web shop, that they are running smoothly. And the other thing is that there are lots of questions. For example, is the database fast enough? Which queries are slow? Is the slave in a synchronous state? Is it consistent? Because it's also important to know some data and mainly performance data to push, for example, the programming department to enhance something. Because yeah, monitoring if MySQL is alive or not is not really so important because our backend system is also running on a MySQL database, so we get so people cry very fast if something fails. So mainly it's important to ensure that everything is running smoothly. So what can be done for MySQL monitoring? Of course, Nagios or Isigna plugins are available, many. One question I would like to know of you, how many of you are using MySQL somehow in your environment? Okay, most of you. And how many are monitoring it somehow? Okay, most of you too, so seems we are on a monitoring conference. Yeah, for example, one plugin here is the Check MySQL D plugin. You can make use of, there are various other plugins, of course. What we especially want to ensure is that the slave does not fall behind in some way. So we are using a Percona monitoring plugin to ensure that. So another thing we want to ensure is that the slave has the same data as the master. So we have the Percona monitoring plugin for the table checksumming, and we are running the table checksum itself is started by the cron daemon in a periodical manner, and the The plugin just checks if it's in sync or not. My experience there is that normally, yeah, it's in sync most of the time, but there happened a few times in the past that some kind of query did not go through the slave daemon. So yeah, we had to fix that and notice it. Here is a complete list of the Percona monitoring plugins available for Isinga. There are many plugins available, and I think they are quite useful for monitoring MySQL, for example, to check LVM snapshots. You can check here if the LVM snapshots are running out of space, something like that. You can check, for example, the MySQL file privileges. You can check the PID files, the process list. There are many, many options. And even you can check the memory usage in a nice manner. For example, the buffer cache and something like that is important to check on a system. Yeah, other solutions, of course, exist for Sebix. I never tried that myself, but I checked, and there are plugins available, of course, for that. What we personally are using is the MySQL CACTI templates. They are now also part of the Percona monitoring plugins since, I think, maybe a year or a bit less. And you get just a huge list for the MySQL different performance datas. And it's not for monitoring so much, but for the performance data, you can evaluate the data very nicely. And you get a historical overview with the RRD tool, graphing, of course. So, for example, the MySQL command counters, you can see here, this is a few days. Yeah, we can see especially the very small peaks. I think they are somehow at midnight where we do some backup stuff, and the other peaks are just the normal peaks during the day. As we can see, yeah, we have, of course, have mostly select commands. Not too much other things happening, of course, since it's a web thing. Or the MySQL network traffic, and I think maybe there are about 20, 30 different graphs you are getting very easily when you're using the MySQL CACTI templates, so it's quite an easy thing to set up and nice thing to know. So you can just watch out how are the graphs developing over time, and yeah. What is also available is control base, but it's kind of dead, it seems. I checked it in the past years over and over, but nothing really happens on the web page or anywhere else. And for example, if you check in the forums, someone asked in September 2011 if it's still being developed, the product, and yeah, after 1 year, there was some kind of response, but not really much. So the forum is dead and the website seems to be dead, so it seems to me that it's not used anymore. Anybody used control base in the past or rare? Okay, so user base doesn't seem too big. What can be done on the commercial side? There's the MySQL Enterprise Monitor from MySQL Oracle. The thing is, you need to get the more expensive subscription, the Enterprise subscription. The standard subscription is not sufficient to use the MySQL Enterprise Monitor. So the Enterprise subscription costs about $5,000 per server per year. So if like we have, for example, two or three MySQL server, it's quite amount of money you have to pay for that. So I already asked at Oracle if we can get that separately, but that's not possible. Here are some screenshots from the MySQL Enterprise Monitor. It's a web interface based on Java, and yeah, you get different advisors. You can analyze the queries. You can check the replication. It's, I think, in kind of functionality the most powerful thing for MySQL that exists. In the graphical user interface section, and here's another graph for the queries. You can get queries that are executed most of the time and that have the longest execution time. So it's a good starting point to analyze what queries are slow and should be done in a better way. So maybe I think graphical user interfaces are a good thing for people to visualize, of course. Another commercial tool is the Monyok tool. It has quite a good feature set, and it's very cheap compared to the MySQL Oracle thing. It starts at $200. It's also web-based. You can see the different tabs over there. And one feature, for example, is the track config feature. Simple feature, but quite nice too. You get an overview what you have changed in the past in the MySQL configuration. Chat Profiler is also available as a commercial solution. There exists a limited free edition, but I think it's a bit too limited to make really sense, because as you can see, there are many tabs grayed out on the top. For example, you're not getting the slow queries in this tool, so it's a bit sad. And for the free edition, and if you have a look at the top queries, there is the note about that you should upgrade to the paid version. But the paid version, okay, it starts at $500, so would be affordable. Anybody using some of these tools here on the page, the commercial tools? Okay, so seems that mainly open source monitoring tools are used, because most of you are monitoring MySQL, as you told before. What can be done on the command line? There are open source tools available, of course. Again, Percona is very strong here. It was formerly called Matkit or Aspersa, and they merged it somehow, and now everything is called Percona, I think for marketing purposes mainly. But if you have a look at the available command line tools, that's quite a good list. For example, you have this the ptconfig diff command, or you can the ptheartbeat command. The ptheartbeat command, for example, does not make use of the seconds behind master variable that MySQL offers, but it introduces a more reliable way to get that out. I have some more examples here now. I already mentioned the config diff command. You can see that here, for example, you easily see what has changed. The other thing is the heartbeat stuff. You see there's just a timestamp that is added in a fixed interval you're deciding on, and so you can compare the master and the slave timestamp value, and so you see how long it takes to replicate to the master and how far it is behind. What's nice to get an overview of over a MySQL system is the ptmysql summary command. It's very easy to use, and you get a nice overview of what's happening on this server. So if you maybe are a consultant or something like that, that would be quite useful, I guess, because you get lots of information in one step. The pt query digest command can be used to get an overview about the queries running on the system, what queries are taking most of the time. The queries are normalized somehow, or so that the different parameters are not relevant for the queries. And they get the query ID. You have here the ranking, for example. There's a special select query that takes takes approximately 30% of all the queries response time. And yeah, the queries are grayed out here because I did that on a production system and yeah, don't want it to offer any points for attacks or something like that. Yeah, and then you can have a detailed look at the special query. For example, this query with query number 4, you can see the where it spends time, how many rows are examined, and other informations. And also you have here stats about the query time distribution. Are there any queries that take a shorter period? Are most of the queries taking a longer period? So you can check that easily here. So it's mainly for optimizing purposes to see what can be done to make better queries. PT show grants is just a easy way to get all the grants that are configured and the user permissions on the MySQL server. You don't have to check the MySQL database tables, so you get that nice commands out here. There's also a Percona Toolkit variable advisor. It just gives hints what can be enhanced, what can be done to make the system maybe better, maybe not better. So yeah, there are also various other command line tools. I know, for example, the MySQL tuner, Perl utility. There are many tools. You just start on a server and you get recommendations what should be optimized. I think it's not always the best way to do it like that, but yeah, it's maybe sometimes a starting point. Okay, what can be pitfalls for the monitoring thing? On the one hand, you have to think about that monitoring also generates a system load. So I read many users reporting that they have a very maybe enhanced MySQL monitoring, so it also can add quite a load to the system. So you should keep that in mind. For all the tools, you normally need some kind of MySQL user, and you should of course use a somehow limited MySQL user. It's often maybe very comfortable to use the root user in the first step, but I think it's not the best idea to do because of bugs, and just set the permissions correctly. And to connect especially to the graphical user tools, you should use a secure connection definitely, because I noticed that some tools don't really remind you of that. That could be a good idea. So you can run the MySQL server with SSL enabled, or you can make an SSH or VPN tunnel to ensure that. And of course, to ensure a good uptime, you also should monitor hardware with IPMI, the operating system, but most of you will know that. And last point, the backup should be automated too. Otherwise, those things can happen to you. So in this case, the school lost all of its students' database, so the backup strategy doesn't seem to be quite enhanced. So now to the next part of the presentation. It's about the management thing. How MySQL can be managed, what can be done with the MySQL internal tools, and what other tools are available to manage MySQL in one or the other way. One good starting point for queries is the slow query log. It logs the execution time in milliseconds, and the nice thing is if you set long query time to zero, just all queries are locked. So if you have a look at that, you can see the on the first screen, you can see the query time took 0.000378 milliseconds. Okay, seems so. Very fast, of course, yeah, because there are only 10 user entries in this table. So there's also the general query log, but the general query log I would not recommend to use that anymore because it does not log any execution time. It just logs all the MySQL statements, but I think this is not really necessary today most of the time. Because yeah, it's better to use binary logs for purposes of updating or altering data. So just use slow query log if you want to get something out of MySQL. And the MySQL D binary offers a funny feature. So you can just say MySQL D minus minus help and it warns you about the syntax errors you have in your configuration. I was searching for some nicer option, but there is not really a config check, or at least I did not find a config check option. I just found that because I think if you start MySQL D without the minus minus help, it just starts and not sure if it warns you. Okay, what's also interesting is the profiling feature that is integrated into MySQL. You can activate that by setting profiling to 1. This activates the profiles for the queries that are following in the session you're connected to. In this example, set profiling is enabled. Then I enter the use database and next the select command, and with show profiles you can have a look at the queries executed. Here it resulted in 4 queries, so select database, show tables, and then the actual query. You can see the duration here. It was 6.8 seconds, so I wanted to have more details about that special query. So just ask show profile for query number 4. So you get a quite detailed overview what the query is actually doing in MySQL and what takes a long time. So you see here, most of the time is spent in copying things to temporary tables. So there should be fixed something that temporary tables are not necessary to execute the query. Maybe you should add an index or something like that. Yeah, also the show command is nice to use in MySQL. You have lots of show options here, show status, show variables. You always have to keep in mind the global scope, because if you are connected in the MySQL shell, you can decide if you want to query the variables in this session or the global variables, so you have to take care of that. You can get the InnoDB status with the command. And yeah, the process list. And what's interesting is that the tools that are analyzing the queries, for example, the Percona toolkit query digest command, it can on the one hand take as input the slow query log, or if that's not possible on a server because maybe you can't enable the query logging for some reason, it's also possible that this query analyzing tools make use of the process list, so they're monitoring the process list and get out the queries of the process list. Or the last option would be that the TCP dump is used to get out the queries from that are sent to the server. Of course, that only works if you aren't using SSL secured MySQL connections. Yeah, here the show status for percent queries. It shows that there were 416 million queries, and luckily no slow queries. Of course, you should check how the long query time is set here, because it could be that maybe it's set a bit too high, because zero slow queries is not that useful at all, if you get that. There's also the explain command. You can use the explain command to let MySQL explain how the query is executed. So it tells you something about the query execution plane and that stuff. What's also very nice in MySQL is the information schema and the performance schema. You can just use plain SQL to query many, many things. Here two examples for the information schema. For example, with the first query, you get the top five tables in kind of size. So yeah, you just get a list very nicely. And the next query is to get the queries per second with a MySQL with a SQL query. So yeah, that could also be easily used to implement some kind of individual monitoring, to implement some kind of plugin for Isinga. What's quite new in MySQL is the performance schema. It's implemented as a storage engine, and it was introduced with 5.5 and is currently extended in 5.6. So 5.6 will be available soon, I guess, because they already have a release candidate for that. So the future, I think, will be that you can use performance schema for analyzing queries. I had on the last on the slide before, I forgot about that note. It says that the show profile thing is deprecated with the newer 5.6 MySQL release. So I guess with the next major MySQL release, the profiling feature I described here will be dropped some day. So you should keep that in mind if you're implementing something with that. Yeah, and another tool is InnoTop. It is just a top clone for MySQL on the command line. It's for interactive monitoring. And the funny thing is that it's not limited only to InnoDB monitoring. So as the name would suggest, you can use it for other information too. It's not part of MySQL. You have to install that separately. Here's a sample screenshot for the web page. You're just seeing what MySQL server is currently doing, and other things like the slave SQL status, the slave IO status, the master status. You just get a nice overview what is happening on the system with one command. Yeah, there are also graphical user interfaces for MySQL management. Maybe all of you know PHP MyAdmin, I guess. There are also integrated monitoring and analyzing features. Like they also give you advices on the different MySQL server settings. And another thing is the Adminer, browser-based management GUI. It is a single file, and it says that it's more secure and better than PHP MyAdmin because they had security issues in the past. But yeah, it's actively maintained, so if you keep it up to date, I think it should be fine. MySQL Workbench is directly from Oracle, and it's the successor of the MySQL Administrator. It's a tool that has integrated an SQL editor. You can do the database modeling in a graphical way, and you can do the server administration. You can do the configuration. You get the log files, and you get quite a few things. It's available as an open source edition, and in addition as a commercial edition. The commercial edition has some add-ons like the validation or the DBDoc. support. SQL Yoc is also a management GUI. That's a commercial one, so I think it starts at $100, and you can use that for managing the MySQL server too. Here are some links about the literature I can recommend. A very nice and huge thing is the High Performance MySQL book. It's available in the third edition. I think it appeared in April 2012 or something like that in the third edition. I really can recommend that if you don't know that and want to have more a deeper insight into MySQL. It's done two by the Percona guys. MySQL performance blog is also interesting to just check what they are writing. The Planet MySQL page and the MySQL DBA blog can be recommended too. And what I found out recently is the SQL Fiddle site. It's quite a nice thing for testing different databases. I can show you that. That's SQL Fiddle. You just can select a database server and version here. So, for example, they have a MySQL 5.6 version here. You just select that version and you can insert some data. For example, this is a sample data, and you can just then execute the query. It got executed then. You see the result here. In this case, I executed show profiles, and then the detailed profile for query number 2. So here is the. Here it shows what exactly happened. So. Here's a list, for example, about the tables in the performance schema available. There are many, many, many tables, and it just lacks a bit of nice example at the moment for the performance schema because I was searching around quite a bit, but there are a few presentations available from Oracle, but not too much useful things, it seemed to me. So I think it will take some time because the profiling thing is deprecated now in the future released MySQL version, so it will take some time to make use of that in the future. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask. We have some time ready before the lunch, so. So I'm quite interested too if anybody is using some kind of special monitoring solution for MySQL and what your experiences are. Are most of you that said they are monitoring MySQL using just a Isinger plugin that was available, or custom Isinger plugins, or you can also ask in German if you prefer, so. So, yeah. At least it's ensured that you are the first on the buffet and the massage, so.
So, thank you very much, Christoph.
Yeah.